Have yourself a merry little Christmas. Let your heart be light. From now on, your troubles will be out of sight. Yeah. Have yourself a merry little Christmas. May the Yuletide gay. From now on, your troubles will be miles away. Oh. Here we are, as in olden days, happy golden days.
Hey Marbots, it's me, Rogue Marvel Scott. Welcome back to the channel and welcome back to another makeup tutorial. So, if you haven't guessed so far and you haven't really read the title, this is my snowman interpretation. There are lots of snowman makeup tutorials on YouTube I'm aware of, but I didn't want to go through the whole horror route. But yeah, I didn't want to go that way. I wanted to go like kind of like cutesy and kind of clownish and kind of you know, fancy dress, pretty makeup. I didn't want to do like anything too scary. I just wanted to be like really nice and pretty and hey. So this is, I don't know, probably the fifth makeup tutorial that I've done for Christmas, and I hope you're enjoying the series so far. That I hope you're enjoying the days where I'm posting up makeup. If you want to know how I got a chance of, oh, look at that glow. Let it glow, let it glow, let it glow. So if you want to know how I got this look, stay tuned.
So before I get started on doing my hair, I'm going to block out my eyes with some white concealer, and I'm going to blend and blend and blend until practically I need to put a second layer on, because I blended a bit too much and I wanted everything to be opaque when I put it on. So I'm putting on my second layer now, and then I'm going to blend that out, and then I'm going to go on to the rest of the eye makeup. So, using the lighter shade of the Kylie Bible MBH Cosmetics palette, I'm just going to place that all over my eyelids and bring that all the way up to the top where my eyebrows meet as well. Blend that out seamlessly and just keep blending and blending until I'm happy with that, and obviously go into my next eye. Now I'm just using an eggshell colour just to go in the inner corners of my eyes, and then after that I'm going to go in with the whitest white that's in my 120 palette from BH Cosmetics 2nd edition, and I'm going to smear and blend that white out to the corners of my outer corners, if that makes any sense. As you can see here, that's what I'm doing. I'm specifically not being overly neat with this eye makeup because it is a snowman look, so therefore everything needs to kind of come together but also look together and out of place as well. So that's why I'm not being overly careful with what I'm doing. Now I'm going in with a nice light blue just to add some depth and, you know, some crystal-like look to it. You know, like icy bluey, you know, that's what I'm kind of going for with this whole look. Now, using the thinnest brush that I have, I'm going to line my eyes, and I'm going to be using, well, I am using a cream base. I'm actually using a grease paint from my flash palette, like I always use. So I'm just lining my eyes now, getting them to look kind of dark white, sharp, icicle looking. And then I'm going to set that with a white eyeshadow. Going on to my skin now, I've already started. I just applied a white base first, where I highlighted my nose and my head, and then I'm going over that with my natural foundation color, and then I'm going to continue using my natural foundation color, you know, just putting it where I need it to be. And then I'm going to go in with another white shade just to brighten the middle section of my face, because I want this look kind of to look a lot like the Killer Frost look that I did, which you might have seen, but I don't want it to look exactly like the Killer Frost. And that was one of my things that I was actually scared of, that it was going to look exactly like Killer Frost. So now I'm just making a rainbow over my face with a white concealer, well, white based concealer, and I'm doing my forehead as well. And I'm going to blend those out, so everything where you see where I'm placing it now stands out a lot more than my natural skin color or skin tone. Now I'm just going over my forehead again with a cute little snowman, just to brighten it up a little bit more. And yeah, I'm just making sure that I'm keeping the concealer exactly in the spot that I placed it, and just blending out the edges enough for it to look as though it's seamless. Now forgive me on this, but I do highlight the next section before you see anything else. But yeah, you're gonna see. I've highlighted already now, and I'm now going to do my nose using a orange color corrector. And then after I've blended it in, like I'm doing now, I'm going to go over it again, continue to build up a kind of carrot top nose, like you know, traditional snowmen are. And then I'm going to go over the orange with some eyeshadows from the BH Cosmetics. I'm using all the orange shades just to bring in depth to it, and I'm going to also use some yellows and some whites just to make the nose look a bit more 3D-ish and also more like a filter, because I wanted this to look like it was a filter rather than not on my face. I didn't want people to assume, oh look, he has a carrot for a nose. I wanted it to kind of look filterish. I'm also going to highlight that nose as well with some actual highlighter. So I'm just setting my makeup in place, because I'm actually going to wear this out. And I'm now going to clean off my lips and prepare them for when I need to put some lipstick on. And then I'm going to draw on my Kohl freckles. They are called Kohl, right? Kohl. You know what I'm talking about, charcoal. Yeah. So I'm just using a small tipped brush, and I'm just placing big ones as the staples, and then I'm going to go round all of those with tiny small dots. Now it's time for some glitter to add some sheen to this icicle snowman look. Just place it on my chin and on my eyes, where I place my eye makeup, just to make that eye makeup pop as if it's, you know, all frosty and snowman. And I'm going to place it on my forehead as well, and just areas where it's nicely highlighted. Setting that in place because I don't want the glitter to move. I'm now going to take a Snapchat filter. Hey. Now I'm lining my eyes with a jumbo pencil from NYX in Milky White, just to bring in, you know, make my eyes look a bit more bigger than usual. And then I'm going to start doing my eyelashes, I believe. So you guys know how much I hate doing my eyelashes on camera, so I never actually do, but what you can see is I'm placing them on after they've become tacky, just leaving them on. So I've left the right one on for quite some time, and then I'm just placing that into place whilst the left one is just doing what it's doing, lingering there like a leaf in the wind. I don't know. See, just picks it up and pops it back on. And fixing it into place. It was kind of hard doing that because of the grease paint, but it did eventually find my skin. Just applying some mascara to those eyelashes just to give them more of a coaly black look. Well, just more dark. And I'm going to place some eyelashes that I've cut underneath on my lower lash line, making sure that they stay in place onto the skin where I've just lined my eyes with eyeliner. And I'm also going to add some mascara onto this. Now you can see that I placed this straight onto my eye without even making it get tacky too fast, but to tell you the truth, I knew they weren't moving anywhere. Yeah, they literally didn't move anywhere. Time to add my frosty lipstick, and this lipstick is from Freedom, I believe, and it's Freedom's Star Wars inspired lipstick range, which I've got all of them. I will leave it in the description what the name of the lipstick is, but I can't remember what it is now. But just bear in mind, it is a lovely shade to wear anywhere. To be honest, you don't need to be wearing it to be frosty or whatever. It is a nice shade. Just going on to do my hair because I'm finally getting the look all finished up. So I'm using a spray that I found in Superdrug, and I bought quite a few of these. This is the grey one. It's not white, it's actually grey. And I'm using some bobby pins to place my hair in place, twisting it and just pushing those pins. If you're a girl, you know how to do your hair with pins. If not, I'm just twisting and placing those pins in, and this is pretty much the look. So I'm gonna stop talking now, and I hope you enjoyed the song. The artist is so great. I'll put his name in the description, or her name.
So that's how I got the look, guys. If you're interested in seeing more, don't forget to subscribe and press the notification bell, you know, next to the subscribe button, next to my name, next to Planet Marbasia, and you know, you'll get a chance to see through your emails as and when I upload. I do try to upload every Wednesday, every Thursday. Sometimes it doesn't work out like that because I am a full-time worker. I am a teacher. So therefore, it's hard sometimes, but I try my best. So that's it. Don't forget to comment what you'd like to see on the channel or what you'd like to see me do next. And I'll see you soon. Bye.